What's up everyone, Darcblade here with another preview guide for Monster Hunter World Iceborne. In this episode we're going to take a look at the new moves for the hammer. The hammer in Monster Hunter World Iceborne hasn't received many changes, but what it has makes the weapon far more manoeuvrable and fun to play. This mainly revolves around being able to use your clutch claw and slinger after certain charged attacks to either keep up with a monster or control their movement, allowing you to hit them with follow-up attacks. But anyway, let's get into the video and talk about the new moves. First of all is the aim slinger. This is done by holding L2 whilst your weapon is unsheathed. This can then be followed up by pressing R2 to fire off whatever slinger ammo you have, or circle to fire your clutch claw. This will allow you to grapple to a monster's position, and after which you have a few options available to you. You can either press triangle for a normal attack with your weapon that will weaken and tenderize a monster's body part, or alternatively, if a monster is tired, you can press circle, especially while on its head, to make it change position, and then you can press R2 again to do a slinger burst to fire all your current slinger ammo into a monster's head, sending it careening forward, and if it hits a wall, it will be stunned and knocked out for a bit. However, the hammer has new additions on top of this. It has access to the slinger burst. Now, should you be charging your weapon, if you press L2 during the charge, you'll fire off a slinger burst. This is a short shotgun-like blast with your slinger. This can potentially interrupt monsters depending what slinger ammo you are using, and during this your charge on your hammer will continue. So it's a way to interrupt a monster, keeping them in place and allowing you to continue charging your weapon to follow up the slinger burst with a heavier hit. The hammer also has access to claw attacks after charged attacks. Now there are two forms of this. One of them results in a flying smash move, the other results in a spinning flying smash. So first of all, the flying smash. This is done by performing a charged upswing 1 or 2, and then after the move you press L2 to allow you to fire off your clutch claw, grapple onto a monster, and then fling yourself into the monster, hitting them with the hammer as you land. Alternatively, you can perform the spinning flying smash, which is a harder hitting move, but requires you to perform the charged big bang attack first. So you charge your weapon fully whilst your weapon is power charged, and then after you performed it, press L2 to grapple onto a monster and send yourself spinning into the monster's body with the weapon, causing massive damage. Alternatively, you can perform the flying spinning smash following a wall run attack or a sliding attack, which I believe is called the mid-air spinning bludgeon. After you've latched onto the monster as well, using either of these two moves, you can perform your standard clutch claw moves to either tenderize a body part with triangle, or alternatively, send them careening into the wall with a slinger burst. So that's about it for the new moves for the hammer. Now, like I said, it hasn't received as many new moves as some of the other weapons in Monster Hunter World Iceborne, but what it has received fit really well and synergize with the hammer's current movesets. Being able to grapple onto a monster following certain moves helps its combos and in a way allows a hunter to keep up with a monster. Also being able to use the slinger burst to interrupt a monster while you keep charging your weapon also helps. And I think hammer mains in Monster Hunter World Iceborne will be very happy. But anyway, don't forget to check back soon when Monster Hunter World Iceborne releases, as I'll be doing full guides for all the weapons in the game. And until next time, I've been Darcblade, bringing you a preview guide to the hammer in Monster Hunter World Iceborne. Hope you enjoyed the little video. Thanks for watching, subscribe and like for more.